We're back, and today I want to talk to you about the Midwife's Brew versus castor oil for labor induction. Hi, my name is Brittany Kelly. I'm a mom of four, and this channel is all about encouraging and supporting moms through those first formative years of motherhood where we are trying to focus on being super moms without being perfect moms. If that sounds like something that you like, something that you're into, come on and join the family, hit the subscribe button, go ahead and hit the like button since you're there, and let's talk about the Midwife's Brew versus castor oil. Now, I wanted to talk about that today because I got a lot of moms, okay, this week, more than normal, hit me up and say, hey, Brittany, I had an amazing experience using the Midwife's Brew. It worked really fast for me. Thank you. More than normal, okay? So I'm just like, this is a perfect time for us to have this discussion because some women use castor oil only and it induces their labor, and then other women use the Midwife's Brew, which has castor oil in it, and that induces their labor. So I wanna talk about which one is more effective, just kind of compare the two, and you can tell me in the comment section below if you've used both before, how your experience was with either one of them, or like just compare your experience. I'm gonna compare mine because yes, I did take castor oil alone before, and I have taken the Midwife's Brew. So I know which one works for me. I'm gonna give you my philosophy on why. Let's just get right into it. Okay, so first things first, how do you take the Midwife's Brew or castor oil? So normally women tend to take castor oil alone with something to chase it, something like orange juice, you know, anything just to, you know, go after the taste of taking 1 to 2 tablespoons of castor oil in order to induce their labor when they are full term and they need to induce their labor for whatever reasons that they need to induce, right? It's all personal and individual as to why that's the case. As far as the Midwife's Brew, you have 4 ingredients for the Midwife's Brew, and I'm going to leave links in the description box below for my other videos that actually go over the entire way that you make the Midwife's Brew with the blender. But there are 4 ingredients, and 1 is 2 tablespoons of castor oil, 1 is lemon verbena tea and apricot juice, and then there is almond butter. So simple ingredients that you get from your grocery store, except for the lemon verbena tea that tends to be the hardest to find. But that is the herb, the active ingredient, just like the castor oil is an active ingredient. Speaking of experience, let's talk about anecdotal evidence. First, I'm going to talk about people that have spoken to me directly, and then I'm going to talk about my experience personally. So people who have messaged me and talked to me over the last like 5 years of even talking about this on YouTube and in my personal life, a lot of people who have taken castor oil, it's kind of been 50-50 when it's just been castor oil alone, to be honest. Sometimes it really works for that person and their body responds immediately and they go into labor. And for some others, they get some contractions, maybe an upset stomach, even go to the hospital, but they didn't have a baby. So I see that about 50% of the time. As far as the Midwife's Brew, I really see 9 out of 10 times women actually going into labor. It's very uncommon that, in my personal experience, that people don't go into labor. Yes, it doesn't work for everybody. You know, everything doesn't work for everyone. Show me something that does. Okay, tell me in the comment section something that works for absolutely everybody all of the time, every time. But most of the time, majority of the time, the Midwife's Brew tends to work to induce labor. So in comparing the two as far as effectiveness, it seems that the midwife's brew is more effective. And from my personal N equals one experience, that is the case. For the first time that I ever took castor oil, I have a video up here talking about that experience. I took it with my first child. I tried to induce my labor because I had an induction date come in, a medical one, and I did not want to get medically induced. And I had gestational diabetes, blah, blah, blah. Okay. So I'm just like, I'm gonna take this castor oil. And I did in the middle of the night. My husband was like against it. He's like, you don't need to do that. And I'm like, oh, okay, don't worry about it. Go to sleep. Shh. And then when he went to sleep, I went to the grocery store and got castor oil and took it because, you know, he doesn't understand what it's like being pregnant. You know, he's a guy. He doesn't know. He's the dad. So anyway, he didn't know. So I took it and woke him up like, oh, I need to go to the hospital. Went to the hospital. Nothing happened, you guys. I just had all these cramps and contractions and an upset stomach and no baby. They sent me home. So it did not work for me at all. So the next time when I had to be induced, I decided to, you know, take this old school recipe of the midwife's brew. I revamped it to my own modern day one that everyone tends to use and love, and did castor oil with the lemon verbena tea and the other two ingredients. Now, there is something about pairing that castor oil with that lemon verbena tea and then coating the stomach to make it kind of easy that just had an amazing effect on my body and on a lot of other women as well. I did not have an upset stomach. I didn't have random cramps. I literally started to contract and I went into labor and the baby came the next morning. I took it at night, it came the next morning. And then I did the midwife's brew a total of 3 times, and every single time it worked exactly the same for me. It literally gave me a baby the next morning. Super crazy. So castor oil alone did not work for me. So personally, I'm not planning on having a fifth baby, but if I were to ever have additional children or anything like that, I wouldn't take castor oil alone. I wouldn't, because my experience with it wasn't great. But I do know other people, like, you know, like my sister and everything, who took it and it was just fine for them and it worked for them. So it's all individual, but as far as comparing people coming to me and talking about their experiences and my personal experience, it seems that the midwife's brew is more effective. Now, there's another caveat that I want to talk about with the midwife's brew and its effectiveness. There is trouble getting the lemon verbena tea from your local grocery store. I don't know why, but it tends to be harder to find. So I always order mine off of Amazon ahead of time, get that 2-day prime, and it get there for when I think that I might have to induce my labor. So if someone's pregnant and they think that that might end up being the case, girlfriend, go ahead and get all of your ingredients ahead of time. Have them in your refrigerator, you know, ready to go in case that's the case, because you might need to order the lemon verbena tea online. But a lot of women actually substitute the lemon verbena tea for other teas, some that have lemon verbena tea in it, some that don't, and still some of them have a great reaction. They actually go into labor and safely deliver their babies, and others don't have their bodies go into labor. I have had many women actually tell me that they had to take the midwife's brew more than once, because the first time they substituted the lemon verbena tea and then finally they realized it wasn't gonna work for them. So then they went back and actually got the lemon verbena tea, did it with the lemon verbena tea, and it worked. So those women to me are similar to myself, where castor oil alone is not gonna put me into labor. But I think the women who can substitute the lemon verbena tea and still go into labor, their castor oil alone probably would have just put them into labor. But the women who substitute and it doesn't work, and then they come back and substitute with, and not substitute, they actually use the lemon verbena tea paired with the castor oil that actually works, that they're more like me, where they have to have those two active ingredients together for their labor to start, to be encouraged. And I think that is really, really interesting. So they will fall into that 90% with me, where it's going to work if you have those things together, those particular ingredients. But of course, then there's that group of women that no matter what, it's just not gonna work for them, and they're gonna have to get a synthetic hormone like oxytocin, synthetic hormone called Pitocin, to actually start their labor and get their labor going. The Midwife's Brew castor oil, it doesn't necessarily like cause the labor. It triggers it. It encourages your body to go into labor because it's the oxytocin, the hormone that you have on the inside, that is pushing your labor along. It's not the castor oil. It's not the lemon verbena tea. It's your body. So it's kind of inspiring it, encouraging it. At least that's what my doctor called it. My doctor called it encouraging my labor, and she was totally cool with it. So I wanna talk to you real quick about the disclaimer here. I'm not a medical professional. I am not giving you medical advice. I am just telling you my personal opinions here. My entire channel is about personal opinions and research that I personally did. So always do your own, always talk to your own provider. My doctors were okay with me taking the Midwife's Brew. Okay, so make sure yours is too. So why do women take Midwife's Brew or castor oil? It honestly comes down to individual issues, whether their practice or them, or they are concerned about babies that are too big that they might not be able to push out, and they might have to have a C-section, or they have a pending medical induction already scheduled. Maybe like myself, they had gestational diabetes and their sugars were really bad, and they, you know, couldn't go past a certain point because maybe your pancreas might give out. Maybe they are afraid of going past a certain point because late-term, post-term babies tend to be more likely to produce meconium, or you have a higher probability of stillbirth. There are so many different reasons as to why women decide that they need to be induced. So with that said, I am not shaming anyone, and I don't think anyone should shame anyone else on their particular reasons. You know, all of our births matter, they're very important, and we just want to have a safe, healthy birth and be able to control the aspects that we can in order to make it as safe and pleasant for ourselves and our babies as possible. Now, some common concerns are that castor oil causes the baby to pass meconium, or castor oil causes a mother to poop while she is in labor, and that's castor oil whether it's alone or in the Midwife's Brew. There is no known scientific reason as to why some babies pass meconium and some don't. It doesn't matter if the mother had castor oil or not. Babies sometimes pass meconium in the womb, and that can be dangerous because if they do, they can ingest it or breathe it in, and it gets into their lungs, and that can cause some type of infection. It can be a serious situation. That is not avoidable by not taking castor oil. It is just completely unknown. Some babies do and some babies don't. Did any of my babies pass meconium in the womb? No, they did not. Not a single one out of four. Not one. And I ingested castor oil or Midwife's Brew that has castor oil in it for every single last one of their births. As far as mothers pooping during labor, now I get it because I just did a video about pushing the baby out and how you're told to push like you're pooping, and I personally don't think that imagery works when you're in labor. But anyway, check that video out after you watch this one. But the truth of the matter is, majority of women actually do use the bathroom when they are pushing the baby out or in labor. That makes a lot of sense, right? Because things are moving out down there in that area, and there may be a release. So don't feel concerned about that. Don't feel like it's abnormal. It's totally normal if that happens. It did not happen to me for any of my labors. It just didn't. But for me, TMI, I do throw up in labor. That's a sign that it's gonna be time to push soon for me. So, you know, I guess it came out the other way, whatever, don't worry about that. We're in labor, it's fine. All right, so I'm glad that you stopped by today to have a little chat with me. Make sure that if you aren't subscribed, take the time to do so now. Share my channel with your friends so that I can continue to help support moms through their first 5 years or so of motherhood. And if you're into early education and parenting from a full cup, this is the place for you. I love you guys so much. You just don't understand. You make me so excited when I see your comments and we talk and we dialogue. We talk over on Instagram. I just love it here. I'll see you in the next video.